Very few people are aware of milk depleting the calcium from our bones, and a health study found that those people who consumed the most calcium from dairy foods increases fracture risk than those who rarely drank milk. Human is the only social animal who used to drink milk of other animals. Say for example cow's milk is custom designed for calves, and weighed around 45 kilograms at birth. Due to our ancient survival needs, human acquired the habit of drinking another species' milk of cow, goat, etc. All of us had noticed that unlike humans, cows, goats and all other mammals once weaned, never drink milk again. Calcium is needed for our heart, muscles, and nerves to function properly and for blood to clot. Inadequate calcium significantly contributes to the development of osteoporosis. Study had revealed that adult people who used to drink milk regularly are more prone to osteoporosis. Like any other animal-derived protein-rich food, milk has a positive potential renal acid load, PRAL, which triggers a protective biological reaction to neutralize all the damaging acidic protein before it reaches the kidneys. The body is designed for survival, so it sacrifices bone density to protect the kidneys and urinary tract, because the latter are essential to survival. The first and most readily available source of acid neutralizer is in the bones. So even though milk contains calcium, it ends up sapping your bones of that crucial mineral. Studies have also revealed that Monsanto's hormonal milk poses serious risks of breast cancer, besides other cancers. Do you know that calcium is an absolutely critical nutrient in regulating alkaline balance, called pH, in the blood? When blood pH starts getting low, down to 7.35 from a baseline of 7.4, calcium starts getting released from the bones to bring alkaline base balance back into balance. The pH of blood is of critical importance to sustain life and controls processes as varied as breathing rate and the ability to transport oxygen in blood cells. Our body needs vitamin D to absorb calcium. A person without enough vitamin D cannot form enough of the hormone calcitriol, known as the active vitamin D, which leads to insufficient calcium absorption from the diet. In this situation, the body used to take calcium from its stores in the skeleton, which weakens existing bone and prevents the formation of strong, new bone. There are two types of vitamin D known as vitamin D3 and vitamin D2. Vitamin D3 is the type of vitamin D which our body produces in response to sun exposure, while vitamin D2 is not. The further we live away from the equator, the less vitamin D we can make during the winter period. When we used to go out during daytime, avoid taking an umbrella, instead wear a sunglass so that our body can produce vitamin D3 naturally. Darker the skin, more sun exposure is needed to make vitamin D than a fair-skinned person. Too much exposure to artificial light inside a room also leads to osteoporosis. Avoid using sunscreen regularly, because using sunscreen regularly will block the skin in absorbing sunlight properly, and sufficient vitamin D cannot be created by our body. Lastly, always sleep in a dark room during night hours without using any kind of artificial light. For better bone development, there are very few leafy vegetables that contains very high level of calcium, and this leafy vegetable is one of them and is known as green amaranth, in our local language known as Khutura Xaak. I prefer to call it superfood, because it used to boost bone strength, and eaten once or twice a week can prevent osteoporosis. It should be cooked like normal leafy vegetables to eat, or can be boiled and served with olive oil and lemon.